एयरपोर्ट। राइट, पैसेंजर सर्विसेज। सो व्हाट ऑल कम्स अंडर पैसेंजर सर्विसेज इज टिकटिंग काउंटर्स, चेक इन स्टाफ, ग्राउंड स्टाफ, पीपल हु आर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ चेकिंग इन ऑफ द पीपल, पीपल हु आर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ बोर्डिंग पार्ट, राइट, दैट इज ऑल पैसेंजर सर्विसेज। इवन इमिग्रेशन इज अ पार्ट ऑफ पैसेंजर, राइट। All right, so all the staff taking doing duties for passengers, right, to make the journey smooth for them,
yes,
the
yes.
check-in counter, people who are actually working as a staff for wheelchair passenger, let's say, right,
okay.
So they are helpers, but they come under passenger services, right? So check-in staff, your boarding staff, people who are helping the passengers in boarding, people who are helping passengers in deboarding also.
Okay.
Their duties at arrival or departures. All right. So all these come under passenger service. Even people who are sitting at corporate and making bookings for passengers, for customers, are under passenger services. Right. And what are security? Security people, you must have seen security personnel on the at the airport, right, that you have to go through after immigration most of the time for international flights, but for domestic, after check-in, it's directly security, right? You just have to clear the immigration for international flights, right? So security is there at every point. You enter the airport, you find the security personnel. When you are going after, or when you have to get your baggage through to a machine, right, so that they can screen it, that is a security part. Then during boarding as well, there is always a security personnel sometimes checking your boarding cards, sometimes not. It's up to him, right, because it's the duty of ground staff as well to check the boarding card of individual passenger, right? So all these come under security people, right? You must have seen a lot of security personnel walking with dogs at the airport, right? So these are like taking care of the airport premises, preventing any terrorist activity to happen at the airport, right? So these are taking, those people are taking care of that. Of course, that is not, those people are actually the part of the defense side, not the aviation people, right? But these are like, this is one of the department at the airport, right? Then commercial. You must have seen all the duty-free shops mostly everywhere at every airport, right? So that is the commercial part of the airport. Commercial department, selling things, restaurants and all, right? So that comes under commercial. ATC, who is actually providing information or letting pilot to depart, to take off or land. So pilot always take the approval from ATC to land the aircraft or to take off or to park. All right. So ATC is basically helping pilots to, it's an information center giving all the minor information or major information to the captain, even if they are flying the aircraft. All right. So we have three levels of plane. One is takeoff, when the plane is taking off. Other one is cruise level, when the plane is going just straight. So you are taking off, right? You're taking off like that. And at one certain point, plane become like this, right? And it's just flying straight. We call it cruise level. The other part is descent or landing part, right? So first, plane becomes like this. See? And then it starts landing, right? So we call it descent, and after that landing, right? So takeoff, cruise, descent, and landing. So these are four phases of flight, wherein ATC will be helping, or ATC is helping in every phase of it. All right. So pilot is in constantly in touch with the ATC personnel, and they are helping pilots to fly the aircraft safely, all right? Be it giving them directions, or if they have, touch wood, any problem in the flight, they can communicate, pilots can communicate with ATC, all right, to get the solution of that. Then cleaning services. So most important stuff at the airport, making our airports neat and clean, right? So cleaning services, even these people come on board when the aircraft is like, you know, park at their bay to clean the aircraft cabin so that passengers can board, all right? Nobody wants to sit in a dirty area, right? So the cleaners come into the aircraft to clean the cabin as well. Cabin, galley, flight deck, everything, all right? Then AM, aircraft maintenance engineer. So these people are maintaining the aircrafts. All right, they are taking care of all the aircraft airline have, all right, in terms of serviceability. All of them should be serviceable, operational, all right, with no technical problems in it, right? So all these are the departments of the airport, all right? Any doubts? Okay. And what department cabin crews come under is passenger services. All right. So out of these, cabin crew job comes under passenger services department. All right. Customer services, you can say. All right. Because with lot of airline, we refer passengers as customers. All right. We do not call them passengers. We call them customers. All right. Now, one more presentation I would like to share with you. And it has a lot of information.
Tell me one thing, Neha. If any naughty child is in the boat and makes noises and do naughtiness, and then how can we understand it?
Of course, this is your job. This is your job to get, you know, because all the passengers around him would actually get disturbed and they will come up to you, right?
Yes, okay.
Well, you have to tell to his parents about it, all right? But in such a way that they don't get offended, all right? And most of the parents, they understand it, okay? They don't let their, you know, children running around because they know all of the passengers are getting disturbed. It's just that you have to make them aware very politely. All right, could you please take care of your child? People are sleeping, you know, because most of the people on the road, they have nothing to do. They will just fall asleep, right?
Yes.
So, you know, customers are sleeping right now. Could you please just take care of him for a while? Okay. Or what you can do is, if you think that child is not sitting at all, just offer something to eat. So after telling this to the customer, to the parents, like, you know, could you please just take care of him? Avoid running over here and there. And I can get something to drink for him. What would he like to drink?
Okay.
So the parents will ask from you. So any juice, chips, offer chocolate chips to the kids. All right. Kind of bribing them. Right. To sit quietly. Right. So these things you will handle on board like every day. This is like the very common concern that you have asked, because you will be facing this issue like every day. All right. So this is how you're going to deal with it. So whatever you're telling to the parents, say it politely. Okay. Do not make them offended. And offer stuff from your get. And you will be having stuff for kids. Like, you will be having chocolates, chips, juices, cold drink if they prefer, offer, all right? You will also get toys on board. So this is like most of the airline, they keep some kind of activity toys for kids so that they get busy with that, you know. So if you have, as per your airline, because I do not know about low-cost carrier, I don't think low-cost carrier provide anything of that sort, but mostly full-service airline, they keep such things on board, especially for kids, all right? So you can offer that as well. So now you are aware of the prerequisites to become the cabin. Should be 18 years plus for domestic airline, 21 years plus for international, right? Then aspirant should have passed 10 plus 2 from a government recognized board and university or university. So that is the minimum that they're asking for, okay? But it is always good to check what requirements they're looking for, because every airline, they have different requirements for cabin crew job, right? So this is generally I'm telling you, but always check the prerequisites to appear for the interview, all right? Minimum things that they are asking for. For some airlines, swimming is must, that you know, you should know how to swim, and that is also a part of their recruitment process, okay? So always check what they're looking for. Height criteria is 157 centimeters minimum for domestic airlines and 160 centimeters and above for international. This can vary airline to airline. All right. So you have to make sure that you are following the criteria and you are falling under this as well. All right. Your height should be minimum 160 for international, and always check their requirements as well. Because I think one airline, Zoom Air, they started their operations in India a few years back. I don't know how they're doing now, because I did not hear anything about it. I don't know if they're still operating or not, but when they started hiring cabin crew, the minimum height criteria was 5 feet 6 inches. So that was like 168 centimeters for domestic. They have their own criteria, right? So over 167, 168 centimeters they are asking for. And it is just domestic airline. I don't know if they are still operating. I think I'm not sure. But I think not. I haven't heard anything about it. Whenever I have traveled, like in these few months, I don't even see their aircraft at the airport. So assuming they are not operating anymore. Right? So now these are the essentials. Must be able to read, write, speak in English and Hindi for domestic airlines. So English and Hindi, both of them are important if you want to become a part of domestic airlines. So announcement that I made you do, right? All these announcements you need to make the announcement in Hindi as well. All right. So this also be available in Hindi. You have to say that in Hindi as well. And with domestic, you always start with Hindi and then you say in English. All right. All airlines require fluency in English. You must have a good level of English to be able to pass the interview. Right. So you need to excel in this language, because this is, first of all, internationally accepted. All right. And this, your interview will only happen in this language. They may ask you to read out something in Hindi just to make sure your Hindi is also fine to make announcement and to converse with people. All right. Because there will be a lot of flights wherein you will get passengers who do not understand English. And with them, you have to convey your message in Hindi. So in the interview, interviewer may ask you to read out something in Hindi, or they may ask you to answer few questions in Hindi only, right? But mostly interview will happen in English language only, right? English skills are an important part of your training. So your entire training will happen in English only, except the announcement part, all right? So you will practice your announcement in Hindi and English both. But if I talk about the trainings of service, grooming, and safety, that will all happen in English. Your manuals that you'll be reading from will be in English language only. All right. In addition to that, no tattoos in sight. All right. You should not have any tattoo on your body, especially in the visible part of your body, like, let's say, you know, your wrist or hand or neck, which will be visible even after wearing the uniform. All right. So no tattoos in sight. Good health. You will need to go through medical tests. All right. So every airline conducts these medical tests before they hire you as a cabin crew. All right. Since that job needs you to be in perfect medical condition, like perfect health with no medical condition. All right. That's why they always conduct medical tests. You need to be fit medically. You should be healthy. All right. Otherwise, you would not be able to take care of the passengers on board, right? Now, the most important slide that I want to cover, some qualities a cabin crew should possess, right? Positive attitude. We have been speaking about this, right, from in our past slide as well. Presentation also, we covered this topic already. Positive attitude. Always, always have positive approach towards any situation. All right. Reflect you have positive attitude. Do not pretend it, but reflect it. Okay. Patience. So patience is the key for, I think, anything. All right. And you need to be really, really patient on board with a lot of passengers you have to take care of. Maybe with that kid also, which is actually annoying all the passengers on board. Right. So you just need to be patient. Do not scold anyone. Okay. Do not get angry on anyone. It will be your loss only, because that person can complain against you, right? You just need to be polite. If you think still the passenger or customer is not listening, trust me, your airline will take care of their employee first, all right? Most of them, they are like that. And you can always raise this issue to the airline, okay, to look into the matter. If it gets little really worse, I'm talking about, maybe passenger who is not listening to you at all, and also, in addition to it, it's also creating or jeopardizing the safety of the aircraft, all right? Like, whatever he is doing can also harm other passenger or himself, all right? Maybe just not fastening the seatbelt. It's a serious issue. Passengers not fastening the seatbelt for takeoff or landing, it's a serious, takeoff and landing is a serious issue, right? If he or she is not listening to you and saying, you know, I'm okay, I'll be fine, do not worry about me, I can take care of myself, I don't want to fasten the seatbelt, la la la, then you have all the rights to complain about him to your supervisor and also to the captain. All right. So you have few rights on board, but do not misuse them. All right. Because at the end, airline will investigate thoroughly to check whose mistake was it. All right. And did you convey your message politely? Did my, like, airline would see, like, did my employee did everything in a right way? Okay. So use everything like in a right manner. Okay. Do not misuse anything. Okay. Because you should inform your supervisor in any situation, but deal yourself first with that situation. All right. You need to be patient with your colleagues as well. All right. So every day you will be getting different set of team to work with. So that is the best part of the aviation. All right. So what you can what you need to do is, maybe someday you find someone wherein you're not getting along with him or her. All right. You guys are not working not synchronizing, let's say. So just be patient with that person. thinking that you will not be working this with this person tomorrow, it's okay. I can deal with him or her today. It's absolutely fine, right? And just do your work. Focus on your work. You will be getting your zone to work on. You will be getting your set of passengers to serve. He'll be getting another set of passengers to serve. You just focus on your part. Okay, you don't have to say anything to anyone. Help everyone if they are asking for. You can also ask for help from people if you are facing any difficulty on board. Okay, but if you think somebody is not getting along with you, do not take it personally. Let it be. Okay, maybe you will not fly with that person ever. Maybe you will not see him or her in your roster ever in life. You can pray for that, right? Assertive. So assertive, be assertive or being aggressive. It's a very thin line between these two terms, all right? Assertive can easily be judged as being aggressive, but you need to take care of that, okay? So you do not need to be assertive like in every, in like normal flight as well. Being assertive means you are actually instructing someone to do something in a very assertive manner, in a very confident, like let's say one person is not, the same example, not fastening the seatbelt. You will say once politely, twice politely, sir, please, this is the requirement, otherwise you would not be able to land the aircraft. And then sometime you have to say it assertively, sir, please fasten your seatbelt. All right. So be assertive with everyone to get your work done, but do not be aggressive with anyone. Okay. Do not show anger or something. All right. So that is how you should convey. Professionalism and responsibility. All right. We have been talking about this as well. Professionalism. Always maintain professionalism, especially when you are in your uniform. All right. So Qatar is actually maintained, their cabin crew actually maintain high professionalism when they are, let's say, just walking at the airport. They are very professional. And this is what they expect from you. Responsibility. Take your responsibilities very seriously. Fulfill it every day. Whatever task you have been given, make sure you fulfill it in order to have a successful flight. All right. So professionalism and responsibility. You know what your responsibility is on board, be it from safety aspect or service aspect or five-star customer service skills, customer service, then you should fulfill all these responsibilities. All right. Empathy. We have been talking about empathy as well. Remember I told you service recovery, what you can do is listen to a person first. If a person is complaining, listen. Second was empathy. Tell him that you really, really understand what is from, like, where is he coming from, right? Tell him that you understand and you will see what best you can do for him. So it's like empathizing, you're actually feeling what that person has gone through. All right, or going through, right? We say it, step into a person's shoes. Okay, you can acknowledge that to empathize. You just need to acknowledge the concern, all right, to empathize with that person. Customer service skills. So now, after that, we're going to cover customer handling, all right? So there are a lot of skills. You have these skills in you already. All right. You are polite. You are friendly. All right. It's just that in this job, you need to be like that every time. In your personal life, maybe you are friendly at times. You are polite at times, right? It's up to the situation. But in this job, you have to have this entirely, like every day, especially when you are in the uniform. All right, anywhere, at the airport, at the hotel, or on board. All right, so customer service skills to deal with the customers, to deal with their concerns and problems successfully, to provide them resolution, to give them solution to their problems, if they have any complaints, to rectify it. okay, even if it has nothing to do with you, customer is just upset from the ground staff. You cannot just come up and say, so what, that was not my mistake. No, I didn't do it, ground staff did it. But it was still that airline, right? The ground staff is also representing the same airline as you are, okay? So you do not blame someone else. Or if a customer is unhappy with the ground staff of your company, of your firm that you're working for, then you should rectify on his or her behalf, all right? Empathize first and come up with the best solution in a very polite manner. And all these things come under customer service skills, all right? And airlines like Qatar Airways, who this year also got number one airline award by Skytrax. All right, so we are actually winning this award from past few years. All right, we are in top five from past many years. All right, just fluctuating between second or first. All right, last year we were number one. Today, this year also we are number one. All right, Qatar Airways. Why? Because they provide five-star customer service skills. I mean, they provide five-star customer service on board. Skills is something their cabin crew or their ground staff or their employee, they have it. That's why we are achieving it, right? Eagerness to learn. So there will be a lot of changes in the program, as in they every day your airline will introduce something new on board, okay? Just to keep their passenger engaged with them, all right? So if they just continue with one kind of food, let's say, or one kind of service, passengers at the end will get bored and then they try the other airline, right? All they need is something new, something exciting on board, which keep them engaged with us, right? That's why we have frequent flyer program. We can get the membership signed from them, and it's like they are member with us, they get few benefits out of it as well, and mostly they choose us to fly with, right? So eagerness to learn is, you should be eager to learn whatever changes are being doing, are being done in the airline, all right? So whatever they are changing, you are the one gonna learn it, you are the one to convey to the customers also, that this is something we have just introduced, would you like to give it a try, right? If they are introducing any offers on the flights, always convey to your customers. It comes under five-star customer service skills, all right? That you are actually helping enhancing the business also, right? Getting more revenue by making them aware about the offers that your airline is offering, because not all the customers are just sitting and exploring the website, right? Okay, so you can tell them. Eagerness and your training, as I mentioned, gonna be a rigorous training of 2 to 3 months. All right, so you should be willing, you should have that zeal and passion in you to learn all about it. All right, sometimes you may feel to give up, but do not, okay, because that training is worth doing, all right, worth learning about the same. Then active listening. Again, we have been talking about it a lot. Okay, make it a habit to listen to a person first and then talk. All right. If you are amazing listeners, you already have one of this skill, customer service, five-star customer service skill. Okay, if you can listen to someone, and listen just doesn't mean you are listening and not responding, means not acknowledging. It is always, always important to acknowledge someone's problem. All right, or maybe he or she is just sharing his or her experience. Okay, like people really, really like to talk on board because they get bored, and always they come up to the cabin crew to talk, to chit chat. They start telling their experience they had in any destination, let's say. Then you will get bored listening to them as well. Like being a cabin crew, I always, you know, got bored while listening to their stories. But of course, I cannot, put that on my face, right? So I listened to them and acknowledged, participated in the conversation, right? So do all these things and you can achieve D this customer service skill. So customer service skills is not important. 5-star customer service skills are important, right? To make you a 5-star crew, right? Now, tips to help you pass the interview. I told you what all rounds would be there in the recruitment process. One-on-one would be there, all right? Group discussion would be there, okay? Then height measurement, wherein they will measure your height in front of them, all right? Most of the airline, they only have these rounds, okay? They conduct one-on-one twice sometimes, wherein in first one, they just ask maybe one or two questions about introduction and why you want to become a captain. But in the second round, when it goes further, they add a few more questions. That is mostly the last round, right? So one-on-one group discussion, some airline also conduct swimming test. All right, that is also the part of their recruitment process. So practice. More you use a language, the better you become at it. If you think you are lacking somewhere in any language, be it Hindi or English, practice that language more. All right, because you want to pass the interview, you want to crack the interview, you have to improve. Right? So, skill like a language can be improved, right? If you practice more and more, right? So this skill can be enhanced, can be improved. What you need to do is you just need to practice. Strive to become better. It's okay if you are not able to clear the interview in one, all right? You do not have to take it literally personally. You can try for it again. You just need to strive to become better than before, right? Whatever bygone be bygone, okay? Like you can say, jo ho gaya so ho gaya, it's done, right? Strive to become better. Always strive to become better than whatever you've done in the past, okay? If you have cleared in one go, amazing, all right, amazing. But if not, then do not get disheartened. Always try for another one, and always try for the same airline again. It's absolutely fine. All right. Some airline, they have requirement to wait for 6 months before try for them again. But most of them, they do not have such requirement. You can always, always check. All right. Check either on their website, or you will get a lot of forums on Google as well to tell you about it. Research. It's good to research about the airline. Since Qatar Airways has won this prize, this award this year of best airline by Skytrax. Now, what all interview will be happening for cabin crew, imagine someone just mentioned about it, some cabin crew or some partis candidate, all right? Some candidate mentioned about the award in the interview. It's a plus point for him or her, right? Now, Qatar Airways knows that this person has researched about us. He knows that we are winning team. And we have won a lot of awards in the past as well, right? So always accumulate these kind of information, okay? Always check on Google, all right? Always follow such pages. If you do not want to research every now and then to put something on Google, just follow some pages on aviation, and you will get these kind of updates. So I have done that. I'm following few pages wherein I get to know about it. I'm following Qatar Airways on LinkedIn, right? So you can make your account on LinkedIn, right? You can follow the companies that you like so that you get updates on their performance, right? So research about any airline you want to give interview for, so that they know. And you can always add that in your answer to show them that you know about it. So what if you have researched a lot about an airline, but you did not mention anything in the interview about it? How will the interviewer know that you have done your research, you have done your homework as well, and you know, you are passionate about it, that you have already read about a lot of our achievements, right? So always show them, okay, but make sense before you speak, okay? give the answers carefully. Okay. Like if someone asks you, for example, if I'm giving the interview for Emirates and I have heard Emirates is again doing pretty well. Maybe Emirates did not win any award this year or last year by Skytrax, but it was Emirates also in top 10 from past few years. All right. So I can mention that I've been checking or I've been seeing Emirates is doing pretty great, that we are always in top 10 list from past 5 years. That's why I want to become a part of this winning team. Right. So that means this person has researched something about it. And even though we are not at first position, still, you know, I actually appreciate Emirates to be in the top 10 list, right? In top 10 airlines. Then read instructions carefully, right? The instructions, what instructions am I talking about is, in the past slide, I spoke about prerequisites, the minimum thing that they're asking for. So these will be the instructions that you need to read. Okay, what is the minimum height criteria? What is the education qualification they're asking for? And if they're asking for swimming test or not, all right? Because if you don't know swimming, you will not appear for the interview, right? There is no point to appear for the interview if you do not know swimming at all, right? And maybe they have this requirement to pass the interview, right? It's a part of the recruitment process. So read the instruction carefully, right? Just 1 second. I was reading the other day. I saw that Indigo is hiring right now. And I'll share that with you as well, Suparna. And they have mentioned a lot in their requirement list. I just need to find that link.
You are telling that their requirement is also streaming. I don't understand.
No, but with Indigo, it's not mandatory.
Okay.
That with Lufthansa so far. Anyway, so I will share the link with you and I can tell you what kind of instructions I'm talking about. All right. So read instructions carefully whenever you are appearing for the interview. Keep it simple. Okay. As I already told you, to keep your answers as simple as possible. Okay. English should be okay, but you don't have to literally put complicated words in it. It's absolutely fine. Okay, you need just a simple language to convey your message, right? Convey your thoughts, your feeling, your ideas. So it should be just simple. That's why I want you to keep your introduction as simple as possible, because I don't want interviewer to get questions from your answers, all right? Like maybe you mention out of nervous or stress something else and they are actually putting up more questions on it, and then you will become more nervous and then bam, right? So that's why whatever questions they're asking for, just you do not have to, I mean, do not frame the answer in your head as in the entire answer. You can always think of the pointers. But when you start translating your answer in English, you always mess up while talking. Yeah. Focus on the question asked. So always focus on the questions, whatever they are asking for. Okay. Do not just start answering. Do not jump the gun. Okay. At that point of time, you have all the rights to be patient, wait for a few seconds, and then start answering. But do not show that you are pretty nervous. That's why you are thinking. Okay. It's good to go pretty slowly, you know. Just modulate your voice and tone and pitch. Okay. Plan your answers. It's like plan your answer ahead of your interview, a day ahead of your interview. Okay, even when you're waiting for your turn, you can always plan. Like, if they ask this question from me, this is what I'm gonna answer, and then you will remember it. Okay, and there are few questions that are very frequently they are asking in the interview. First of all, you can write it down. One of them is why you want to become a cabin crew. Right, and one more thing I want to ask you, Suparna, like, in which field you have done your graduation and post graduation?
Graduation combined graduation, and post graduation I did as a correspondent in English.
Okay. So still, your field of study is pretty fine. It's okay. They cannot come up with some question, because there are a lot of people who have done, let's say, BTech, or let's say they have done MTech as well, and then they're applying for cabin crew. So this can be a question from them. But why are you changing your field when you planned engineering for yourself? Then why cabin crew? But in your case, it's absolutely fine. There is no such complicated question come up. Okay, because I have done English as well. So it's absolutely fine. So plan your answers as per the question that will be asked. And this is one of the frequent asked questions at the interview. Why cabin crew? And let's say they can ask about a scenario on board. They can ask, first of all, they can always ask, what do you think are the duties of cabin crew?
Okay.
What do you ask for you? Okay, so they know you are a fresher. Okay, they know about it. But they can still ask, as per you, what do you think your duty is going to be? So then you need to research. Okay, okay. I'm going to tell you, your duty, your primary duty is to take care of the passenger safety.
Okay.
Then to provide 5-star customer service on board.
Okay.
Right, to cater their request,
okay,
to ensure that they are having comfortable journey with us,
okay,
so that they deboard happily from the aircraft. You know, these kind of statements will actually make a very positive point for you. All right, to make sure all the passengers are deboarding happily, like that. So this is my duty.
Okay.
Right, but always mention the primary duty is the safety.
Yes, primary.
Right. So plan.
If they ask why you want to become a cabin crew, what should I tell? What should I say? It's just I like to become.
Yeah, I know, it's very vague. What you can say is, you can either tell your actual thoughts about it. Like, for me, I was very passionate to become a cabin crew. And I also added a few lines, like, I like meeting new people. I like meeting friends every day. And I think this is the job that would help me do that.
Okay.
Like, I like to travel.
Okay.
And this is the kind of job that would actually pay me to travel. Right?
Yes.
So that kind of points you can add. Okay.
Yes,
but
yes.
Keep the travel part at the end.
Yes.
First,
yes.
You know, I really like to talk to new people. Yes. And all you can add over here is one more thing that let the interviewer know that you have learned about the airline, you have researched about it. So
okay.
I have heard, like, okay, we have almost 150 nationalities working with Qatar Airways. I would love to be a part of such environment.
Okay.
Right? So things like that you can mention. Now, interviewer know that you have already done your research, like how many nationalities are working with us. And now, you're also passionate about it.
Okay.
I love to travel. These points can be added. And I always find this job very fascinating.
Yeah.
Is working as a cabin crew, and they have told me all the positive experience that they are experiencing with their company. or they can ask, then they can ask this question. Any airline can ask, like, let's say, why Indigo? Yeah, why SpiceJet? Right? Then you have to do your little bit of research. Why are you looking to become a flight attendant with SpiceJet? Okay, you can add a few points. I really, really love the uniform. But these points come later on. First of all, you have to tell about the achievements. I have done my research and I saw there's a lot of growth opportunity with this airline. Even one of my, you can create story over there as well, but just know what you are talking about. One of my friend is also working with SpiceJet and she is doing pretty great with you. So I actually got fascinated by her. Right, so these kind of story, they're not going to ask you the name of cabin crew or something. Of course, a lot of cabin crew working with them. Okay, but even if you name any, they're not going to go and do the research. Okay, they do not have this much of time. So, create
the story. Yeah. Then also, I can take your name. You're already at there.
But I was not with SpiceJet. But you know, there are a lot of Nehas in the world. Right? A lot of Neha. I'm sure there are a lot of Neha working with SpiceJet also. Right? So you can take the name or just create stories like that. But first of all, always start with their achievements. Always start what good you have heard about the company. I've heard you guys are giving amazing growth opportunities to your cabin crews. And to be honest, I really, really love the uniform. Like that. One of the questions. And question can be also as per the scenarios on board. Okay, they know you are the fresher, but they just want to know your ideology. Like, what do you want? What do you will do if you get stuck with this kind of situation?
Okay,
they want you to think about it. They want you to imagine. They want you to come up with an answer without the training.
Okay. Okay.
Right. So, kind of that stuff.
To check my intelligence, right?
Yeah, to check how far you can imagine, how you can manage. So whatever you do in your, let's say, regular life, in your daily life, that kind of answer you'll be giving over there, right? A customer gets upset from you. What if your customers get upset from you? Right? How you deal that? In the same way, you're going to deal the customer, right? So if you do not care about a family member who gets upset with you, you will not be having any answer about a customer getting upset from you. Hmm. You will not be able to think, how I'm going to manage that? What if that customer is going to be rude with me? Hmm. Right? So that is how, so they want to see what kind of personality you have. Hmm. Are you friendly? Are you polite? Okay. Or are you a person who cannot say sorry at all? Because being a cabin crew, this is one word you will be saying every time.
Yes.
Say sorry, even if it is not your mistake. Okay, I'm being honest with you. Anything happens on board, customer is not happy about, you are sorry for that. Okay. I apologize. I'm sorry. If something has happened from the catering part, let's say the food is bad, it doesn't taste good, then again, you are sorry for that.
Okay.
Now, the way to get started is to quit talking and begin doing. So we have done a lot of talking in these 5 days. Now all we need to do is start doing our stuff. Okay. Start doing and achieve the dream. Right. Any questions?
No, all good.
Okay. And you know, one question can appear in an interview. Like, you know, your roster or your schedule is going to be pretty hectic.
Okay.
And since you haven't done any kind of any such kind of job, how are you going to manage it? Right? And since in your case, Suparna, if you mention that you have a 3-year-old daughter, then this question will surely come up. How are you going to take time for her?
Yes.
You will be, sometimes you will, you'll be flying at night, let's say.
Yes.
But you're landing early in the morning or flying early in the morning and staying somewhere else for a day and, doing layovers and all that. How are you going to manage? Do you think your kid will be able to manage without you? Right. So then you have to be really positive about it. Yes, because my family members are very supportive. All right. So they will take care of my kid. All right. And like that, you have to come up with some positive answer. And I will take care of my sleep pattern and all, even with my kid, I can do that, right? So these kind of things, just to ensure that you are a perfect person to be a cabin crew, right? Otherwise, they'll be thinking, I don't know, this lady has a kid, she will be busy with that. I don't know if she'll be able to manage her sleep patterns or not.
Yes.
Maybe she's not fit to fly later on because she is not sleeping properly.
Yes.
So you just need to make them sure, you have to assure that person that even though you are dealing with this responsibility, are absolutely fine to deal with other responsibilities as well.
Yes.
Because it's your job.
Yes.
Okay. Let's begin the travel adventure. Great. Okay. So any questions in that? We have covered all the topic, all the qualities I told you need to have to be a cabin crew. Trust me, you already have these qualities, and it's just that it will come out as per the situation. All right. But just make sure to have the positive approach towards anything. All right. Sometimes you would be literally not well rested or tired, mentally not fit to do a flight, right? Maybe angry on someone. So you need to keep all these emotions aside and then do your flight. All right. Any questions, any doubts, anything you want to ask? Okay. Now we'll come to the customer handling part. Okay. Few scenarios I have written. You will come across every day in your life once you become a cabin crew.
Can I take 1 minute?
Sure. No problem.
Thank you.